It seems to me that a lot of new photographers are preoccupied with the idea of having a unique style, something that sets them apart from other photographers. I think this is a very good idea, however, having some sort of style like I have a desaturated look style and that's why you should hire me is ridiculous. It's a very shallow way of thinking about your photography. My goal today with this video is to encourage you to think more deeply about what your photography is about so that you can A, enhance your skills as a photographer, B, stay motivated as a photographer, have a compass to follow, and C, to distinguish yourself to your clients or to potential clients. And the best way to do that is to have a mission statement. Know what your photography is about. If you ask me what my photography is about, I will tell you it's about emotion-filled candids and interactions. That's what I'm about. I look for natural moments. And finding natural moments is not a trick. It's not like a random, arbitrary style. And staying true to this has really helped me separate myself from a lot of other photographers. Now, as a side note, it's kind of been weird because I don't know if it hurts or helps me. But since I started as a photographer, the trends have kind of come around to where my way of thinking, where before it was about cheesy poses and weddings and stuff like that, and I always thought they were ridiculous, and I said, no, I just want to capture real moments. I'll shoot the formals, yeah, but other than that, I want to capture real moments, and the trends have shifted, and that seems to be more what photography in general is about now. But there's always going to be trends too. And if you're just going with the trends, if you're following a trend, no matter what that trend is, it will look bad most likely in 10 years. Just look at 80s photography, even look at 90s photography. You can look at photography in the early 2000s and they all look dated if you follow the trends. If you got married in the early 2000s, you probably have a photograph of your flowers in color and everything else in black and white. That's super tacky. If you got married in probably like 2009 or 11-ish, you're gonna have that vintage look where everyone was tinting their photographs and it looks really bad. It looks really, really bad. It looked bad then, but it looks worse now. So you need to ask yourself, what is it my photography is about? What can I do that's unique? What do I do that no one else can do? And that's how you're going to find your answer and how you're going to stay motivated. If there's purpose behind your photography, you're not going to burn out. But if you're just copying and imitating, it's going to be a job for you. And you're not truly expressing yourself as an artist. And that artistic expression is one of the factors that's going to keep you interested in this job long term. Burnout is real. You have to love what you're doing and you have to have actual purpose. Pretty much every job I shoot, when I pull up, because I arrive early, I meditate for at least 5 minutes and I think about what are my intentions for my photography in general, but for the job I'm at. What am I here to do? What do I really want to capture? And that goes a long way. It keeps me focused, it keeps me engaged with my craft, and it ensures that my photography continues to improve. I'd love to hear what your mission statement or what your photography is all about in the comments. If you're new to the channel, please like and subscribe, and thank you to all my Patreon supporters. Every time I get a new one, it's like a big moral boost. It keeps me going, even though I do this to help other people. When people show me that appreciation, it really means a lot to me. It actually brightens my day. All right, thank you guys. See you in the next video.